Hello friends, so in last lecture we were solving examples, so let us see the next example that I am going to take from page number 659, page number 659, example number 26. After this we will see some theorems, two more theorems are left, we will see those two theorems and then we start 12.4. So this question is prove that the sum of prove that the sum of angles in the four segments exterior to a cyclic quadrilateral R is equal to six right angles that means 540, 6 right angles, that is 9 into 6, that we have to prove. So let us first try to understand what question want to say, that if we have a circle now what we have to prove that the sum of angles in the four segments exterior to a cyclic quadrilateral. So first of all, now I will draw a cyclic quadrilateral in this way. This is a cyclic quadrilateral, let it be ABCD. Now sum of angles, which angles which are in the four segment exterior to cyclic quadrilateral. This is the cyclic quadrilateral, then four segments which are exterior to the cyclic quadrilateral are, this is the first segment, okay, this is the second, third, fourth. In these four segments, whatever angle we will get, suppose the angles in these four segments be angle P, Q, R and S. For a while, I am conceding that angle in these four segments which are exterior to the cyclic quadrilateral ABCD are PQRS. So we have to prove angle P plus angle Q plus angle R plus angle S is equal to 6 right angle, that is 6 into 90, that is 540. So let us see how to prove this. Given ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral, okay, ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral, angle P, angle Q, angle R and angle S are angles in the segments, angles in the exterior segments, of quadrilateral ABCD. Okay, now what we have to prove angle P plus angle Q plus angle R plus angle S is equal to 9 into 6 into 90, that is 540 degree, that we have to prove. So a small construction is required. Let us see how to do a small construction. I can say join PC, this PR, and this PB. Okay, join PC, PR, and PB. Okay, construction, join PC, PR, and PB. Let us see how to prove this. See, we have to prove P plus Q plus R plus S equal to 540 degree. So if I say this is angle 1, so I can say angle 1 plus angle S is equal to 180, because D, P, C, S are on the circle, and we know that opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are is 180 degree. Similarly, I can say, okay, here this PR is not actually required to be joined. Okay, this angle 2 plus angle R, okay, join PC and PB, that is sufficient. 2 plus R is equal to again 180. Similarly, I can say 3 plus Q equal to 180 degree. Okay, P plus S, sorry, 1 plus S, 2 plus R, 3 plus Q. Their sum will be 180 degree. So when I join these two equation, here I will get S plus R plus Q, and 1 plus 2 plus 3 gives me P. And on the right hand side, I am joining 3 times 180, which is equal to 540. So here I can write angle 1 plus angle C, sorry, angle S is equal to 180. Then angle 2 plus angle R is again equal to 180. Then angle 3 plus angle Q is equal to 180. And reason for these three, I can write opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral, opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. Okay, now adding equation 1, 2 and 3. On adding first, second and third, what we will get? Angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle S plus angle R plus angle Q is equal to 180 plus 180 plus 180. So at the place of 1 plus 2 plus 3, I can write angle P. Therefore angle P plus angle Q plus angle R plus angle S is equal to 540 degree. Hence proved. Okay, so please note it down, then we'll see the next question. now we'll see the next question. Or before move to the next question, we'll see the remaining two theorems. Okay, so theorem number according to the sequence, that will be 17th. A cyclic trapezium is isosceles and its diagonals are equal. So next we will see this theorem. Okay, theorem is a cyclic trapezium is isosceles and its diagonals are equal and its diagonals are equal. Okay, that we have to prove. A cyclic trapezium is isosceles and its diagonals are equal. So if I say this is a trapezium ABCD, okay, this is a trapezium ABCD, and here AD equal to BC. So we have to prove, AD equal to BC. It is given, it's a cyclic. So as it is cyclic, so first let me draw the circle. Okay, that means there is a trapezium whose all four vertices are on the circle. So I have to prove this is isosceles. A, B, C, D. I have to prove AD equal to BC. Okay, so what I have given AB, CD is a cyclic trapezium. AB parallel CD to prove AD is equal to BC. Okay, we have to prove this. So if I join this AC and BD, also we have to prove AD equal to BC and AC is equal to BD. That also I have to prove. So okay, so see one thing that I can directly have, that this actually I am trying to prove these two triangles congruent, ADC, okay, and CDB. Okay, CDB. These two things I need to prove. Okay, because as soon as I prove these two triangles are congruent by CPCT, I can say AD equal to BC as well as AC equal to BD. So both things can be proved by saying that these two triangles are congruent. So here two things that I am getting directly. The one thing that these two angles are equal. Why these two angles are equal? They are in the same segment. Okay, as well as DC is common. Now what I need? I need one more angle that I can say are equal for this trapezium. That means for these two triangles. So okay, so I need to prove angle D equal to angle C. This angle, complete angle D, I am saying this is angle 1 and this I am saying as angle 2. I need to prove angle 1 equal to 2. 3 and 4 are equal because they are in the same segment. Now, when I say 1 equal to 2, 3 equal to 4 and DC is common, so I can say that triangles are congruent by angle, angle, side. So now I have to concentrate how to prove angle 1 and 2 are equal. Okay, so a small construction is required. Construction: join AC and BD. Join AC and BD. See, it's not that much difficult as it's a cyclic trapezium. Simply, I can say 1 plus ABC is equal to 180 because in a cyclic quadrilateral, opposite angles are supplementary. Also, I can say 2 plus angle ABC is equal to 180 degree. Why 2 plus ABC? Because it is given AB parallel DC. So these two are the co-interior angles on the same side of the transversal. So their sum moment will be 180. From these two, I can say 1 equal to 2. Okay, so let us see how to prove it in steps. Angle 1 plus angle ABC is equal to 180 degree. Equation 1 and reason: opposite angles of a cyclic trapezium are supplementary. Okay, angle 1 plus angle ABC equal to 180 degree. Now, angle 2 plus angle ABC is equal to 180 degree. Let it be equation 2, and reason behind this as, co-interior angles as AB parallel CD. Now, from first and second, both are equal to the 180 degree, so they must be equal to each other. From first and second, I can say angle 1 plus angle ABC is equal to angle 2 plus angle ABC. Therefore, you will get angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Let it be equation number 3. Now, it's very easy. Simply, I'll take triangle ADC and triangle BCD. Okay. Now, in triangle ADC and triangle BCD, and triangle BCD, angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Reason: angles in the same segment. Angles in the same segment. And name of the segment is DC. Angles in the same segment DC. Angle 3 equal to angle 4. Angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Reason: we just proved. So from, I can write here from second. Okay, I proved it already. So from third, not second, from third. And DC is common. DC is equal to DC. Side DC is equal to side DC. That is common. So here I can say therefore triangle ADC is congruent to triangle BCD. Triangle BCD, reason: angle side, and hence I can say AD equal to BC as well as AC equal to BD. Reason: CPCT. As the triangles are congruent, corresponding parts will be equal. Hence, proof. Okay, so please note it down. Then there is one more theorem. That you have to do by your own. Okay. An isosceles trapezium is always cyclic. Converse of this. That means if trapezium is isosceles, you have to prove that it will be cyclic. I will give you the short description, but first of all, note it down. Okay, so next theorem is an isosceles trapezium is always cyclic. Okay, that means over there it is given AD equal to BC. This cyclic is not given. Okay, simple, a trapezium is given and it is given it is isosceles. So here you can say it is given actually that AC is equal to BD. AB parallel CD, so here given AD equal to BC, and you have to prove that it's an cyclic quadrilateral. So for that, see these two triangles we can say are congruent. Here I'm writing angle 1, 2, 3. Okay, this is given, this is common, and we know that if a trapezium is isosceles, diagonals are equal. So these two triangles will be congruent. So by CPCT, I'll say angle 1 equal to angle 2. Okay. Now 2 plus, let it was angle ACD. Okay. 2 plus this angle is 180 degree. Now instead of 2, I can write 1. That means 1 plus C will be 180 degree. So definitely it will be a cyclic quadrilateral because sum of opposite angle is 180 degree. Now that you have to do by your own. Okay. Now we'll start questions from next exercise, that is 12.4. Okay, exercise 12.4. In this, we'll start with the very first question. So page number 659, exercise 12.4, question number 1. Okay, question is, prove that the quadrilateral formed by prove that the angle bisectors of a cyclic quadrilateral is also cyclic. That you have to prove. Okay, prove that the quadrilateral formed by the angle bisectors of a cyclic quadrilateral. That means first of all we have a cyclic quadrilateral. Let the cyclic quadrilateral is ABCD in this way. We are not going to take any special type of quadrilateral. That means we are not allowed to take rectangle or rhombus or parallelogram, okay, or trapezium, isosceles trapezium. Okay, so we have a quadrilateral ABCD. Okay, now what we have to prove, a quadrilateral which is formed by the angle bisectors. Okay, so this is the angle bisector of A, this is the angle bisector of B, okay, this is the angle bisector of D, and this is the angle bisector of C. That means actually we have to prove this quadrilateral is also cyclic. In that way we have to prove. Okay, we have to prove the angle formed by the angle bisectors of a cyclic quadrilateral is also cyclic. Okay, let me draw the diagram in a proper way first of all to make you explain this. Okay, so here we have to prove this quadrilateral is also cyclic. Okay, so let me draw the diagram once again. Okay, now this you have to prove is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, if you remember this, we have solved one question of similar type. Over there it was given that ABCD is a rectangle and we were asked to prove this is also a rectangle. So I'm assuming these four points are P, Q, R and S. So here actually we have to prove this P, Q, R, S is a cyclic quadrilateral. So given quadrilateral ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, that is given. Now it is also given that DR, AP, BP and CR are the bisectors of angle ABC and D. Okay, so here I am writing AP bisects, AP bisects, AP bisects angle A, okay, AP bisects angle A, BP bisects angle B, okay, CR bisects, CR bisects angle C, and DR bisects, DR bisects angle D. To prove what we have to prove, quadrilateral PQRS is a cyclic quadrilateral. PQRS is a cyclic quadrilateral. Now, the condition to prove, the necessary condition, sufficient condition to prove that a quadrilateral is a cyclic is that sum of its opposite angle is 180 degrees. So, if at anyhow, if it is possible to prove Q plus S equal to 180 or R plus P equal to 180, it is easy to say that PQRS is a cyclic quadrilateral. So let us see its proof. See, it is also given that quadrilateral A, ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. So as it's a cyclic quadrilateral, sum of its supposed angles will be 180 degree. So here I can say A plus C is equal to 180, isn't it? A plus C equal to 180 degree. So 1 plus 2 is equal to 90. This, if I make it half, so 1 plus 2. Okay, half of angle A is angle 1, half of angle C is angle 2. So their sum is 90 degree. Now similarly, I can say B plus D is equal to 180 degree. So half of B, I'm saying angle 3. Okay, and half of D, I'm saying angle 4. So I can say angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 90 degree, isn't it? Now, if I add these four, that means 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, then it will be equal to 180 degree. Okay, now at the place of 1 plus angle 3, okay, I'm doing in that way. At the place of 1 plus angle 3, I can write 180 minus angle P, isn't it? Because 1 plus 3 plus P equal to 180 degree. So at the place of 1 plus 3, I can write 180 minus P. Similarly, at the place of 2 plus, okay, let me take, this is angle 2, half of C, this is also 2. So at the place of 2 plus 4, I can write 180 minus angle R is equal to 180 degree. Now, this 180 is cancelled. So 180 is equal to P plus R. Hence proved. One of the opposite pair of the angles is 180 degree. So it's a cyclic quadrilateral. So let us see how to prove this in steps. So very first, angle DAB, angle DAB plus angle BCD plus angle BCD is equal to 180 degree. Okay, or I can do one thing more that will decrease the steps. I can write angle DAB, angle DAB plus angle BCD is equal to 180 degree, and at the same time I am writing angle ABC plus angle ADC plus angle ADC is equal to 180 degree. Reason I can start with that only, that opposite angles of cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary, therefore angle DAB by 2 plus angle BCD by 2 is equal to 180 by 2 is equal to, sorry, and ABC, I'm making half of these two equations. Okay, I'm making half of these two equations. So here DAB by 2, here I can write, see here I wrote AP bisects angle DAB. So I can write that is angle DAB by 2 is equal to angle 1. Here angle B, so angle ABC. Angle ABC, that is angle ABC by 2 is equal to angle 3. At the place of C, I can write angle BCD, that is angle BCD by 2 is equal to angle 2. Here this will be angle 3. And finally, the DR bisects, so angle ADC, that is angle ADC by 2 is equal to angle 4. Okay, so here at the place of DAB, I can write angle 1. Plus at the place of BCD, I can write angle 2 is equal to 90, and at the place of angle ABC, so angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 90. Okay, so 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 equal to 90. Let it be equation 1, let it be equation 2. Now adding first and second, what we will get? Angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 90 plus 90. So I'm rearranging them, 1 plus 3 plus angle 2 plus angle 4 is equal to 180. Now at the place of 1 plus 3, I'm writing 180 minus angle P. Okay, and here I'm writing plus 180 minus angle R is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, I can say, see, 180 plus 180 minus 180 is equal to angle P plus angle R, and finally angle P plus angle R is equal to 180 degree. Now P and R are the opposite angles of cyclic quadrilateral, and their sum is 180 degree, which shows PQRS is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, so here reason you can write by angle sum property in triangle APB and DRC. Okay, here I can write by angle sum property, by applying angle sum property, by applying angle sum property of triangle in triangle APB and triangle DRC and triangle DRC. Okay, now finally here I do write P and R, but angle P and R are opposite angles of quadrilateral PQRS. Therefore, quadrilateral PQRS is a cyclic quadrilateral. Hence, proof. So, I hope you got this solution. So, please note it down. Then we'll see the next one. Okay, so now we will see the next question. Question number 2. From the same exercise, same page number, we will see now question number 2. Question number 2. In figure ABCD, diameter ABCD, question is, in figure a diameter AB a diameter AB of diameter AB of a circle bisects a chord. Bisects a chord PQ. If AQ parallel PB, prove that the chord PQ is also a diameter of the circle. Okay, figure is given. Let us draw the figure first. Okay, it is given that AB is the diameter. So it must passing through the center of the circle. So this is AB. Okay, further it is given that AQ parallel PB. AQ is parallel to PB. That is given. AQ parallel PB. So we have to prove that PQ is also a diameter. Okay. So here I am not drawing the center. Okay. We have to prove PQ is a diameter. So given AB is a diameter of circle. Then AQ parallel PB. To prove PQ is also PQ is a diameter of the circle. Okay, so let us see how to prove this. See, to prove PQ is a diameter of the circle, there is one way that if I prove this angle PAQ is equal to 90 degrees. That is the one of the way to prove that PQ is a diameter. Okay, to prove this angle is 90 degrees, see, it is given AQ parallel PB. As AQ parallel PB, I can say sum of these two will be 180, and AB is diameter, so this angle is 90. So but obviously this will be 90, so it's very easy. Let us see its proof. For that I have to join AP. Okay, so a small construction is there, join AP. Okay, join AP. Now we'll see its proof. AQ parallel PB, therefore angle PAQ plus angle APB is equal to 180 degrees. Reason: co-interior angles. As they are co-interior angles, so their sum will be 180 degrees. Therefore angle PAQ, I take it as it is, and at the place of APB I can put 90. Now why angle APB is 90? AB is a diameter and angle in a semicircle is right angle. Okay, so angle APB is equal to 90 degrees. Okay, so here I got the answer. Therefore, angle PAQ is equal to 90 degree. Now, angle PAQ is angle PAQ is 90 degree, and it is the angle subtended by PQ. Therefore, PQ must be a diameter. But this angle is subtended by PQ at the circle. Therefore, PQ is a diameter. Hence, proof. Okay, so please note it down. Then we will see the next question. Now let us see the next question. That is question number 5. Okay, from the same page number, same exercise. Okay, question is, in the given figure, ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. In the given figure, ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral in which over here angles are given, in which angle A is equal to x plus y degree, angle B is equal to y plus 20 degree, angle C is equal to x plus y minus 20 degree, and angle D is equal to again x plus y. Angle D is equal to again x plus y degree. So find x and y. Find x and y. See, it's a cyclic quadrilateral. So here this information that A is x plus y, D is x plus y actually was not required, as ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. But obviously the opposite angles, A and D are not the opposite angles. Okay, so ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, although here diagram is not that much required, but still I am drawing it. It's a cyclic quadrilateral. Simply we have to apply the concept that opposite angles must be supplementary. That means A plus C is 180 degree, as well as B plus D is equal to 180 degree. So let us see. Given and to prove. So ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, solution ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. And opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. And opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplemental. Therefore, I can say angle A plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Now, A is x plus y, C is x plus y minus 20. So here I'll get 2x plus 2y minus 20 is equal to 180. Therefore, 2x plus 2y is equal to 200, or I can write x plus y is equal to 100. Okay, let it be equation number 1. Okay, now similarly I can write angle B plus D is equal to 180 degree with the same reason. Now B and D, B and D, B is y plus 20, so y plus 20 and D is x plus y is equal to 180. So I can write 2y or x plus 2y is equal to 160 degree. That is equation number 2. Okay, x, y plus y, 2y, 20 will come on that side, so 160 degree. Now using these two, I have to obtain the values of x and y. So there are so many ways to get this, but simply what I will do, I can say from here, therefore x is equal to 160 minus 2y. Okay, x is equal to 160 minus 2y. So put x is equal to 120 minus 2y in first. At the place of x, I am putting 120 minus 2y plus y is equal to 100. So this gives you minus y is equal to 100 minus 120, and hence minus y equal to minus 20, which gives you y equal to 20. So I obtain the value of y. Now I will put this value of y in equation 2. Put y equal to 20 in equation 2. So x is equal to 160 minus 2 into 20. So x is equal to 160 minus 40. This gives you x is equal to 120. So these are the values of x and y. So please note it down. See, there is a mistake here. It is 160 minus 2y. So here actually it should be 160 minus 2y. So let me solve this portion once again for you. Okay, we'll put x equal to 160 minus 2y in first. So 160 minus 2y plus y is equal to 100. So this gives you minus y is equal to 100 minus 160. This gives you minus y is equal to minus 60, and hence y is equal to 60. Now we'll put y equal to 60 in, y is equal to 60 in first or in second, wherever if you want. Okay, so x is equal to 160 minus 2 into 60. So x is equal to 160 minus 120, and hence x is equal to 40. Okay, so Now this is the corrected answer. Please note down this one and then we'll come to the next question. Okay, now we will see question number 8. From the same page number, same exercise. Question number 8. In the figure, AB is the diameter. Question is, in the figure, AB is the diameter. Of the circle with center O. And chord CD is equal to radius OC. AC and BD produce meet at P. ACN produced meet at P. Prove that angle CPD. Prove that angle CPD is equal to 60 degrees. Now here they are asking to prove angle CPD equal to 60 degrees. Instead of that, question may be framed in this way, that find the measure of angle CPD. Okay, with all this information, instead of to prove, it can be asked that find the measure of angle CPD. So let us see how to solve this. Okay, so first of all, it is given that AB is a diameter. Okay, AB is the diameter of the given circle. Okay, further it is given, center is O. Okay, let the center is O. Chord CD. Okay, this is the chord CD. It is equal to radius OB. That means we can say OC equal to OB equal to OA equal to OD equal to CD. Okay, OA, OB, OC, OD and CD all are equal. Now further it is given when I join AC, sorry, and produce it, and when I join BD and then I produce it, they are meeting at a point and the name of the point is given P, so we have to find the actually measure of angle CPD. Okay, so what we have given, AB is a diameter. AB is the diameter of circle O comma R. Okay, AO equal to CO is equal to BO is equal to DO is equal to R is equal to CD. So simply I am writing BO is equal to BO is equal to CO is equal to CD is equal to R. Okay, that's it. To prove angle CPD is equal to 60 degree. So let us see how to get the measure of this angle. See, very first thing, see, if you see the question, you find that there isn't any question, any information in the terms of angle is given. Okay, simply they are asking this and none other angle is given. So the very first information, that OB is equal to CD, that means I can say OC equal to OD equal to CD, these two are radii and radii is equal to CD. This gives me that triangle OCD is an equilateral triangle. It means I got this angle 60 degree or this 60 degree or this 60 degree. That means I got one of the angle. Now again, if I think about this triangle, that is ABP, this triangle, I need to get the measure of angle CPD, this, or if I say APB is the same thing. Either I say CPD or if I say APB is the same thing. Now for this triangle, to get the measure of this, I must have the measure of these two angles. So now my target is to get the measure of these two angles. So if I join this BC, so very first thing, that I will get the measure of this angle ACB, isn't it? Why? Because angle in a semicircle is 90 degree. So I will get the measure of this angle. Now I need this angle for that. Okay. Or one thing more came in my mind. As this is 90 degree, I can say this is also 90 degree. Isn't it? Now see this triangle CPB. This angle is 90 degree. If I get the measure of this angle, it will be very easy to get the measure of this required angle. This I got 90 degree bilinear pair. As ACB is 90 degree, I can say BCP is also 90 degree. Now I need to get only this angle. Now see, this CD subtends angle O at the center, isn't it? It also subtends angle CBD over here. So the central angle will be twice of this. Okay, this is 60 degrees, so this will be 30 degrees. So 30, 90, and this will be 60. In that way, we'll get the measure of required angle. Now for this, first of all, a small construction is required. Construction. What is the construction? Join CB. Okay, now let us see its proof. So very first thing, I will get the measure of angle ACB 90 degree. With the help of that, I will get the measure of angle PCB. And then by using the theorem that angle subtended by a chord at the center is twice the angle subtended by it at the remaining part of the circle, I will get measure of this. And then by applying angle sum property, I will get CPD. Okay, so angle ACB is equal to 90 degree. Angle ACB equal to 90 degree. Reason, angle in the semicircle. Angle in the semicircle is right angle. Angle in the semicircle is right angle. Angle ACB. Now I can write angle PCB plus angle ACB is equal to 180 degree linear pair axiom, and this gives me angle ACB is equal to, or I can write therefore angle PCB plus 90 is equal to 180, therefore angle PCB is equal to 90 degree. Okay, therefore angle PCB equal to 90 degree. So here I got this angle PCB equal to 90 degree. Now I will prove that triangle COD is a equilateral triangle. Now, in triangle COD, OC equal to OD equal to CD is equal to R given. Therefore, triangle COD is an equilateral triangle, and therefore angle COD is equal to 60 degree. Okay, now COD 60 degrees, so now I will find CBD or PBC. Now I can directly write angle DBC. Angle DBC is equal to, sorry, angle COD. Angle COD is equal to twice angle CBD. Therefore, 60 is equal to twice angle CBD, and therefore I will get angle CBD is equal to 30 degree. Okay, therefore angle CBD is equal to 30 degree, and CBD or PBC. Therefore angle PBC is equal to 30 degree. Okay, the only thing that I have to write a reason over here, reason is angle subtended by a chord at the center is double the angle subtended by it at the remaining part of the circle. So angle PBC is 30 degree. Now in triangle PCB, by angle sum property of triangle, I can write angle CPB, plus angle PCB plus angle PBC is equal to 180 degree. Therefore angle CPB plus angle, now at the place of PCB I can write 90, and this is 30 is equal to 180. Therefore angle CPB is equal to 180 minus 120, and hence I get angle CPB equal to 60 degree. Now this CPB or CPD is the same thing, so therefore I write angle CPD is equal to 60 degree, hence proof. Okay, so please note it down, then we will see the next question. so let us see the next question. Okay, next question is from page number 660, question number 9. Question is, in the figure, O is the center. And AE is the diameter, and AE is the diameter of semicircle ABCDE. If AB equal to BC, if AB is equal to BC and angle AEC is equal to 50 degrees, find angle CBE, CDE, AOB and angle AOB. Also prove BO parallel CE. Okay, a semicircle is given. So B C D and E, and this is the center O. Okay, so AB, BC, CD, DE and O. Okay, AB equal to BC and angle AEC is equal to 50 degrees. These two informations are given to us. Okay, so let us see how to find this. Okay, so first let me draw the diagram. Here it is, BO is joined. Then BE is this way, okay, as well as CE has been joined. These segments are there and this point is A. Okay, so first of all we'll see what we have to find and what is given. Very first thing, that is AB equal to AC is BC is given. Angle AEC, this complete angle is 50. Okay, this angle is 50, that is given. We have to find angle CBE. For a while I am taking this angle as X, that we have to find. Then CDE. Okay, there is no other angle at that point, so I am keeping it as it is. And angle AOB, that we have to find, that this is angle Z. Okay, now one thing more, here it is given AB equal to AC. So I'm joining AC. As AB and BC are equal, so but obvious these two angles will be equal. I'm saying this is Y, this is Y. Okay, now very first thing, see AE is a diameter, so I can say angle AB E is equal to 90 degree. Angle in the semicircle, isn't it? Angle ABE equal to 90 degree. Angle ABE is equal to 90 degree. Angle in a semicircle. Now, okay, AB equal to BC, AEC is 40 degree. Okay, see this A, B, C and this E. These four points are on a circle, but obviously on the semicircle, but these four points are concyclic. So, therefore angle ABC plus angle AEC plus angle AEC is equal to 180 degree. Now, this angle ABC can be divided into two parts. First is ABE and another one is X. So ABE plus X and AEC equal to 50, that is given, is equal to 180. Also we obtain angle ABE 90. So 90 plus X plus 50 is equal to 180 gives you the measure of X, that is 40. Okay, so here we obtain this angle X. Now, as soon as I got X, I can see one more cyclic quadrilateral, that is B, C, D, E. And the opposite angles of this quadrilateral are D and X. So, this gives me angle C, D, E directly. X, see, this I'm talking about this cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, this cyclic quadrilateral. Now, sum X and CDE will be 180 degree. X we obtain, so we'll get CDE. So we got CBE, that is X. We got CDE. Now we have to find AOB, that is Z. To get that measure angle Z, see, if you observe this segment AB subtends angle Y, and that segment AB also subtends angle Z, isn't it? AB subtends Y. Here I took this, that angle was Y, and that AB subtends angle Z at the center, isn't it? AB is subtending angle Y, AB is subtending angle Z. That means I can say Z is equal to 2Y. Now, in order to get the measure of Z, I need to get the measure of angle Y. And it is very easy. If I apply the angle sum property in triangle ABC, it is possible to get Y. Okay, after getting Z, definitely Z will be 50 degree, because when this will become 50 degree, this is 50 degree, then only I can say BO parallel C. Okay, so I hope you got the basic concept. Now we'll see how to prove in steps. Okay, so let us start this. So what we have given in the figure O is the center, O is the center, and AE is diameter. And AE is diameter of semicircle ABCDE. AB is equal to BC. Angle AEC is equal to 50 degree. Okay. To find angle CBE. Angle CBE. That is X, angle CDE, angle CDE, angle AOB, angle AOB. To prove. Now this is the question in which we have to find as well as we have to prove. To prove BO parallel CE. Okay, so let us see its solution. Okay, construction, so definitely I need to join AC. Okay. construction join AC. Solution. So very first thing I will say angle ABE equal to 90 degree. Angle ABE is equal to 90 degree. Reason, AE is a diameter. AE is a diameter. Okay. Now see, I got the angle ABE. Now ABCE. Now quadrilateral ABCE is a cyclic quadrilateral. Is a cyclic quadrilateral. Therefore, I can say angle ABC, angle ABC plus angle AEC plus angle AEC is equal to 180 degree. Now, at the place of angle ABC, see ABC can be written as ABE plus X. Therefore, angle ABE plus X. Now, at the place of AEC, I can write 50 degree is equal to 180 degree. ABE is 90. 90 plus X plus 50 is equal to 180 degree. This gives me X is equal to 40 degree. That is angle CBE. That is angle CBE is equal to 40 degree. Okay, this is the first thing that I obtain. Angle CBE is equal to 40 degree. Okay, so if I count about list, so this is done. Now I will target angle CDE. CDE. So as soon as I got X, now I can say BCDE. Now quadrilateral BCDE is a cyclic quadrilateral. Therefore, I can say angle CBE. Therefore, angle CBE plus angle CDE plus angle CDE is equal to 180 degree. Now, CBE is 40 plus angle CDE is equal to 180. Therefore, I can say angle CDE is equal to 140 degree. So, that is the second measurement that I obtain. Out of three, I obtained the two. Now, angle AOB. Now, to get angle AOB, that is Z, I need to get angle Y. So, now in triangle ABC, AB equal to BC. AB is equal to BC, that is given. Therefore, now angle opposite to AB is angle ACB. Therefore, angle ACB is equal to angle BAC is equal to YC. Reason, in a triangle, angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Okay. In a triangle, angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Now, in the same triangle, in triangle ACB by angle sum property of triangle, I can write angle ACB plus angle BAC plus angle ABC plus angle ABC is equal to 180. Therefore, Y plus Y. Now, at the place of ABC, I can write ABE plus X. ABE plus angle ABE plus X is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, 2Y. Now, angle ABE is 90 degree. X is 40 degree, 180 degree. So, therefore, 2Y is equal to 180 minus 30, that is 50. Therefore, y is equal to 25 degree. Okay, so here I got the measure of y. Now this y and z have a relation that angle z is subtended by AB at the center and y is subtended by AB at the remaining part. So z, that is AOB, should be twice of y. So AOB will be 50 degree. So this is almost done, but first of all note it down up to this point, then I will give you the remaining solution. Okay, so now let us see the how to solve it further. Okay, so now angle subtended by, now angle subtended by a chord at the center is twice the angle subtended by it at the remaining part of the circle. Therefore, I can write angle AOB is equal to twice of y. Therefore, angle AOB is equal to 2 into 25, that is 50 degree. Okay, now angle AEC is equal to 50 degree. AEC equal to 50 degree. Okay, this is 50 degree. We obtain AEC 50 degree is given. Therefore, angle OEC is equal to 50 degree. So, therefore, angle AOB is equal to angle AEC. But these angles form a pair of corresponding angles with BO and CE. Therefore, BO parallel CE. Hence proof. Okay, we proved as well. Okay, and over here we obtain angle AOB, that is angle AOB equal to 50 degree. Okay, so that is the remaining solution. Please note it down. Okay, so that is all about this lecture. Now we'll meet in next lecture and we'll solve some more questions from the exercise. Till then, bye. Thank you. Take care. Stay at home.